it's the whole thing's epic. Today, what we're doing is we're collecting brook trout and part of an effort to restore brook trout populations. And so we're on the stream where we're fortunate enough to be able to have enough brook trout to remove fish from, and we'll take them to another stream to put them back in where they once were. And the way that we figure out where to get fish from is pretty neat. We do a lot of extensive work where we go across the mountains, where we electrofish, try to find brook trout populations, and then we also do quite a bit of work where we look at their genetics, where we try to understand what the genetic composition of a population is. And that's because way back in the late 1800s, early 1900s, really extensive and intensive logging practices and land use activities did a number on many of our populations. And that's why many of them are gone and they're not where they are today. And that's why we have to put them back in certain places. So through that genetic analysis, we can figure out which populations can remove fish from, to take fish from, to put elsewhere. And it helps us have an inventory of our populations, not only physically where they are, but genetically what they are as well. And so we take all that information, utilize that to help make those decisions on where to go and what to do. And so today, we've identified a source population where we can get fish from, and we know where we want to move them to. And so we're able to take a handful of fish and move them up to another stream and then get that population started. And then we do that work this time of year. We do it in the fall, right before they start to spawn. And that gives us a chance to collect fish, move them to the stream that they're heading to, and hopefully they have a chance to spawn once they get there. Yeah, so one of the things that we do is we try to catch them. How we do that is through the work that seen the videos of us electrofishing. And basically we're just making electrical current, and fish have what's called a swim bladder. And so the electricity hits the water, the fish get stunned, and because of that swim bladder they float, we net them. And that lets us be able to collect them, and then we'll weigh them, we'll measure them. We'll take a small tissue sample, continue the genetic research, and then once we've got them collected, then ultimately we'll move them to the stream where we're looking to get them to. And then you'll see right after we sample, they're back upright and they're swimming and they're ready to go. Well, knock on wood, we've been fortunate. We've been able to see fish persist where they've been moved and see reproduction. And that's the key. It's not just getting them there and having them stay there. They need to be able to successfully spawn and produce those next generations that will continue the population through time. Well, my favorite fish is probably brook trout.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a little biased, but again, because of what they are, and the efforts to go into brook trout, them being in the headwaters, we're on the top of a mountain. And so any work that's done to protect and conserve brook trout helps everything downstream. If you know that your brook trout populations are in good shape, that means the headwaters and the very top of the watersheds that everything depends on is in good shape. So things are starting out well. And with that conservation efforts, everything flowing downstream, brook trout are an amazing indicator and a great species to think about in terms of overall ecology and nature and health. And because if we can keep these brook trout populations conserved and healthy, we're doing amazing things, not only for them, but everything downstream as well. And so for that reason, I look at brook trout as a bigger piece to the puzzle than just a fish. Plus, they're really cool. They're pretty, and they're a lot of fun to fish for. But being our native trout, they're just absolutely special.